have been emphasized for the survival of ancestral domain.
The villagers are celebrating a Thanksgiving for a bountiful harvest and peaceful life through songs, dances, and offerings to the ancestral spirits of nature through a holy land. So this is culturally enriching because Silay knots go back to the dawn of civilization, closer look at the development and formation of their culture.
In the middle of the celebration, a group of bandits headed by Lunok arrived to loot the village, abduct the women for their harem, and capture the men to become slaves. The men of Chieftain Bubo, headed by Lawan, fought the intruders. And here the viewers will see a stunning choreography of war scene properly executed to demonstrate proper blocking and levels, just like what you get in a theatrical presentation.
While the fight is in progress, Hugyaw is with Kansilay at an elevated area, viewing the skirmish like a general trying to gauge what his enemy can do. Princess Kansilay mumbles a chant for the spirits of nature to come and help their tribe. Iwaka appears in the sword and fights with Kansilay.
That is a signal for Kansilay and the other maidens to join the fight. Kansilay joins the one at the arena fight. Here we will see how choreographers and fight directors come up with a war dance sequence loaded with energy and enthusiasm.
Bandits scattered with not their gear, making a promise to return. The villagers continue to give thanksgiving, ritual praising, and Silay is showing gratitude to Iwaka for the constant help to the village. Design culture here is well emphasized in the use of Hugyaw as costume. And that's interesting, Hugyaw as costume. Bamboo as materials for varied crafts, and clay for pots and jars.
We gotta wait. Just like the Italians say, good food takes time to prepare. Okie dokie! City of Silay! Make some noise! Aya! Aya Silay! Hugyaw! Kansilay!
Thank you. Good to man.